Hi everyone, and welcome to this Critter Tutorial Bite for Oxygen Not Included. In this video, we're looking at beetas, which are very unusual critters that are only found in the Spaced Out DLC, and aren't like most critters. They really only have one main purpose, which is to refine uranium ore into enriched uranium to be used in nuclear reactors. Naturally then, they are found in radioactive biomes, which are very cold. And jumping into their info, this lines up with their livable temperature range, which is from minus 100 to 0 degrees Celsius. Betas cannot be ranched or groomed, but do have a short life cycle. Instead of laying eggs, they are spawned by a beta hive that we'll look at next. Once the beta is spawned, it lives as a walking bee tiny for 2 cycles, before maturing into a beta for 3 cycles if there is a beta hive nearby. Therefore its full lifespan is 5 cycles long. After the beta dies, it will drop 1 kg of nuclear waste. Betas are aggressive and will sting dupes that get too close, dying in the process, although the damage is small, so this isn't a big problem. But you can put betas to sleep, and if they are in carbon dioxide, they will consume 100 grams at a time and fall asleep for 15 seconds. Now onto the beta hives, which are important for working with betas. This is where the adult betas will bring uranium ore back to get enriched. When the hive has uranium ore to work with, it will glow green and emit pulses of radiation that can be dangerous for dupes. Then, enriched uranium is left behind and must be scooped out by a dupe. To do this, enable harvest in the info card. This can then be collected and sent to a nuclear reactor. And if you want more information on how to run nuclear reactors, then see the Nuclear Power Tutorial Bite. Beware too that if a hive doesn't have enough uranium ore, it will slowly starve and die. Betas are much better than the uranium centrifuge, which is the only other way to enrich uranium. This is because the betas convert 90% of the mass, compared to only 20% in the centrifuge. And even better, betas can collect natural uranium ore, so you don't have to dig it up, which would lose half the mass. Each hive can consume up to 10 kg per cycle of uranium ore, making 9 kg per cycle of enriched uranium. But in practice you may get less, depending on the beta's deliveries. A research reactor needs 10 kg per cycle of enriched uranium, so you will need slightly more than one hive per reactor. I would recommend at least 2 hives per reactor, but the good thing is, it's easy to make more hives. As beta hives spawn a new bee tiny every cycle, they are the way to grow the population. Remember that when a bee tiny reaches 2 cycles old, it will turn into a beta if there are beta hives nearby. But if there aren't, then the bee tiny will actually turn into a new beta hive. By using open doors to make small rooms, we can trick bee tinies into making more hives because they can't see another hive outside the small room. Just build the doors as shown, set them to open, and wait for the bee tinies to make more hives. This is the basis for ranching them, and from here we just need to supply uranium ore. Of course this can be done from around the map, but if this runs out, then there are 2 types of space points of interest that are the only renewable source. These are the radioactive gas cloud and radioactive asteroid field. You'll need to send a mining rocket to these with a solid cargo bay, then transport the collected uranium ore to the betas. For help with Spaced Out DLC rocketry, see the dedicated tutorial bite. But that's all there really is to ranching betas. Put some doors in to make a few hives, feed them uranium ore, and keep the area cold. Then you'll have a good supply of enriched uranium for your nuclear reactors. The last point to cover is how to move them. And note that betas cannot be wrangled or attracted with the airborne critter bait. And as they have no eggs to move, the only way to move them is wrangling the bee tiny. This is possible, but remember that they only remain a bee tiny for up to 2 cycles. Of course that's not a problem within a planetoid, but that does cause some issues when moving them between planetoids in rocket interiors. If the journey is too long, then you'll have to make a new hive inside the rocket and wrangle a bee tiny from here to move them outside again. Or you could simply keep the beta hive inside the rocket and use it like that. A key point either way is that you'll need to make the rocket interior cold enough for betas to survive in, so below 0 degrees. This is probably most easily done by connecting an external cooling loop through the liquid intake and output ports. And that is everything you need to know about betas in Oxygen Not Included. I hope this helps you get that useful enriched uranium, and thanks for watching.